basically was genetically linked to the virus 2019 or 2018 circulating in Pakistan's population group. You might have heard about what we call a vaccine-derived poliovirus, you know, very recently the virus which was identified in Israel, Jerusalem, the UK, the New York, the Canada, same chain of transmission, how people move. That's why it's really, really, this eradication is not merely eradication, but it is a currently global health security issue. The second thing is, it is, as was mentioned earlier, you know, all these efforts in the last 3 decades, I would say, basically it is estimated that it is around, if that would have not been done, around 20 million paralyzed, disabled people, you know, we will be seeing today. So it's an amazing achievement over the period of time. Polio Network has also, you know, has been on the forefront of responding to a number of public health emergencies in a number of countries in the weakest health system, most vulnerable population, very difficult to access areas. This is the network, for example, very recently, you know, the efforts in response to COVID, you know, in a number of those countries, polio was the only network, you know. So it's a really an investment which is, you know, going beyond, I would say, only polio eradication, but in terms of helping the what we call now preparedness and response of different kind of emergencies, as well as, you know, strengthening the immunization system, I would say public health care systems in general, but immunization system in particular. I think there is, as I said, at this point in time, the program thinking is that, you know, we have to really, there is no other way other than to stop this transmission. As you were saying earlier, you know, this is such an infectious kind of pathogen which spreads so fast, it can come back and can really cause paralysis of millions, or if not millions, thousands of children. I already gave you the example. So it's really an investment which goes, you know, beyond only simply eradication. And I really want to take this opportunity to really thank Rotary for the invaluable contribution, particularly when it comes to not only funding, but in terms of advocacy, the awareness, the resource mobilization, the amazing work which Rotary has done. And I think without all the partners are doing a great job, very honestly, without Rotary's, you know, role, this would have not been possible. I just want to give you a quick update, you know, where we stand now. Basically, you know, the overall goal of the current strategy is to, what we would say, certification of eradication by end of 2026. And for this overall goal, you know, we have, I can say, two sub-goals, what we call goal one and goal two. Goal one is stopping the polio, what we call wild polio virus transmission, which is in the only two endemic countries, Pakistan and Afghanistan. And even in these two countries, its transmission now is quite restricted, very limited geographically. And the goal is to stop this transmission by end of 2023. We are still keeping the same goal because we think that end of 2026 6 eradication, certification of eradication possible. We have in the last, from 2016 up to now, have seen multiple outbreaks of what we call vaccine-derived polio viruses and in multiple areas, particularly in African region. The goal is also to stop this outbreaks of these vaccine-derived polio viruses also by end of this year. It's pretty ambitious, but you know, in the context of the overall goal of end of 2026, at the moment we are keeping our goals as it is now. So in the context of these goals, I just wanted to let you know where we are now at this point in time. You just mentioned about the number of polio cases which are reported, 6 cases from Afghanistan and 3 cases from Pakistan, just you mentioned. 2 days before, there is 1 more case which was reported from Pakistan, so it's now, total number is now 10 cases. In addition to this, you know, we also sample the sewage water to see the transmission of polio virus and its presence of this polio virus. So in Pakistan and Afghanistan, while everything was showing a declining trend, but in the last few weeks, we see a kind of an increase in the detection of polio virus in sewage water samples. But these viruses, the transmission is largely confined to what we call eastern part of Afghanistan, which is largely one of the province only, which is Nangarhar province. And within that province also, there are few districts which are persistently reporting the presence of virus. And then just across the border, it's all bordering area where we are really struggling. What we call southern part of a province called KP in Pakistan. You might have heard about North Waziristan, South Waziristan, many security affected areas. So we have this issue in this bordering belt. We also have high risk, and I've also seen virus in Kandahar and in Mandh. The major challenge in Kandahar and Helmand was that we have gained a lot in terms of vaccination of the children, but we are still struggling to gain what we call house-to-house vaccination permission. But we are doing this in rest of Afghanistan, but not in Kandahar and Helmand, the southern part of Afghanistan. This requires a lot of advocacy, of course, from the WHO side. Our director general has traveled, and a lot of other member states, you know, internationally are advocating with the current government of Taliban for their pro-vaccination, but only in Kandahar and Helmand, they are for different reasons. House-to-house vaccinations are not allowed. What does this mean, actually? This means that there is quite a substantial proportion of children who are vulnerable, and this virus, which we have detected in May this year in Kandahar, can really turn into a much bigger outbreak. So far we haven't seen this, but we have seen this virus coming towards the bordering area of Pakistan. All the recent viruses that are detected, they are kind of new introduction into parts of Pakistan. So overall, I would say when it comes to the objective one of or goal one, there is a tremendous progress. Program feels that this is an unprecedented opportunity. We have not seen this kind of epidemiology in Pakistan, Afghanistan since the start of the program. But you know, knowing this virus, this opportunity can also slip away if proper aggressive interventions are not done. So what program is doing is maintaining that intensity and momentum in Pakistan and Afghanistan with a number of different innovative approaches to reach those security compromised, conflict affected, very difficult to access and challenging areas. Also focusing on the community aspects, trying to move from community engagement to community ownership, so that you know all these this acceptance level is goes high. When it comes to the goal two, which is stopping the outbreaks of what we call vaccine-derived polioviruses, there are what we call four key geographies for us where we are struggling. The first is the northern part of Nigeria, northwest, northeast, north central. All these northern parts of Nigeria, not all Nigeria. We are struggling with DRC, which is Democratic Republic of Congo, which is based largely the eastern part of the DRC, which is, I don't know if you might have heard about Tanganyika, Lubumbashi, all those belt. The third area is what we call South Central Somalia, which is again, you know, serious security, you know, compromised area. Access is a very big challenge, and you know it's also controlled by what we call Al-Shabaab in those areas. The fourth area is the northern part of Yemen. You all know about the situation in the northern part of Yemen. We hope that situation will improve with this current dialogues and things which are going on. All these areas, particularly two, South Central Somalia, Northern Yemen, there are factors which are beyond the control of programs, but you know, all these advocacy efforts at the international level, engaging different partners and players, we hope that you know things will improve. We do engage the communities and the local commanders in South Central Somalia. We have able to vaccinate a lot more children than we were vaccinating in past. So we call them consequential geographies. These are, for us, is make or break. The virus, vaccine-derived polio virus in North Nigeria basically led to the infection of 19 countries in Africa. So it's like a core reservoir where the virus kind of come, amplifies, and then export it to the different countries. Similarly, the virus in DRC infected 5 countries. So these are the key geographies where the currently program is focusing on going forward. When it comes to the funding part, you know that GPI has this multi-year budget, which was around a billion for this up to 2026. Our OLIO oversight board has approved the budget for 2024, which is 1.1 billion. So what we are trying to do is that we are making sure that all the efforts to stop transmission in Pakistan, Afghanistan continues, are funded so that the momentum continues and we achieve our ultimate goal. The second priority is to really invest in stopping these outbreaks which I just talked about. Of course, you know, there are limitations. You know, we don't have unlimited kind of resources. So the program has really come up with a good prioritization kind of scheme. So going forward, a lot of focus will be on these geographies. enhancing our efforts, our focus, and cleaning these coal reservoirs in Africa, and focus on Pakistan and Afghanistan to ultimately gain our target and hopefully certifying the eradication of this virus by 2026. Just we'll take one more minute, is that after 2026, we will be entering into what we call post-certification strategy phase, which largely will be, focusing on withdrawal or stopping the oral polio vaccination, and then shifting to what we call IPV. So this vaccination will continue for a period of time, but this is where we stand. And once again, I really want to thank you, and also Rotary in particular, as in general, for the tremendous support and the leadership that they have shown. And we are very close, but we are not yet there. Recent review, midterm review of the strategy, the Independent Monitoring Board has labeled that the goal one, we are off track. The goal two, we are missing the target. We fully accept their things, but we still believe that with all these momentums, with all these efforts, we hope to achieve the certification of eradication by end of 2036. So once again, thank you very much.